Okay, sorry for the interruption. This is question number one. The degree of dissociation of electrolyte is alpha and its penta factor is I. The number of ions obtained by complete dissociation of one molecule of electrolyte is. Alpha is equal to I minus 1. First question, the degree of dissociation of electrolyte is alpha and its Vanta factor is I. The number of ions obtained by complete dissociation of one mole of electrolyte. We have a formula. In the morning class I said alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1. Cross multiply this, alpha into n minus 1 is equal to I minus 1. So alpha into n you have to do alpha n, alpha into 1 that is minus alpha, that is equal to I minus 1. So n is equal to I minus 1 plus alpha divided by alpha. So this is the option. Question number two, you see this, just you look at the diagram carefully. Once you look at the diagram, okay. Look at the diagram. Here the concept behind in this is, diagram is there. This is a semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane allows only solvent molecule pass through it, not solute particles. Here they are expecting blue color. Blue color it is because of ferrocyanide compound Fe3, FeCN6 taken three times. Fe3, FeCN6 times taken three times. This is ferrocyanide compound. This one you have studied in the detection of nitrogen. In the first year, you have studied in the detection of nitrogen, ferrocyanide compound. Okay. But this is not forming here. The reason is that here ions are not moving from semi-permeable membrane. One side to another side, movement is not possible only. This Fe cannot come this side, these ions cannot go this side. So the movement of ion is not possible. Hence, this reaction is not possible. Okay. Next question number. The pH of 0.1 molar, a base, BOH, is a weak base found to be 12. The solution at temperature T Kelvin will display on osmosis pressure is equal to. That they are asking. pH is given 12 in the question. Then if pH is 12, then pOH will be 2. If pOH is 2, then OH minus ion concentration is 10 to the power of minus 2. So we have a formula. OH minus ion concentration is equal to C alpha from the first year. OH minus ion concentration is equal to C alpha. OH is 10 to the power of minus 2 C. See, this is 10 to the power of minus 2 divided by 0.1. Because alpha I wanted to find, so we will get 0.1. Substitute this alpha value in the expression. Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1. This is a formula. Alpha we have calculated it as 0.1. That is equal to I minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. So alpha is equal to I is equal to 0.1 will be the remaining there. This is minus 1. If you go, it goes this side, it comes to 1.1. Substitute in the formula. Pi is equal to ICRT. This I'll write clearly. You see that I have a formula. Pi is equal to ICRT. So I have calculated as 1.1. C is 0.1. R T keep as it is. Then what happens? It comes to 0.11 RT. 0.11 RT is your answer. That is in option C. See students, what is happening here? They are mixing many concepts. One is this formula, pH formula, this OH minus and C alpha, Ostwald dilution law. Using that concept, they are getting this expression and degree of dissociation. Then osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure concept is introduced. Degree of dissociation is there. Ostwald dilution law is there. pH, pOH concept is also it is there. Four concepts are there in this. Right, so that is how it is. Third option. Next question: which of the following 0.1 molar aqueous solution will have lowest freezing point? Which of the following 0.1 molar aqueous solution will have the lowest freezing point? Lowest freezing point they are asking. See, remember one students, one point. Freezing point is inversely proportional to number of particles. Freezing point is inversely proportional to number of particles. Very important expression it is. Okay, here potassium sulfate we have two particles, sodium chloride we have two, urea is one, glucose is one. They are asking which of the following 0.1 molar solution will have lowest freezing point, less freezing point they are asking. So where we are having more ions, you see in the option A we have more ions. Why? Potassium sulfate dissociate gives 2K plus and SO4 minus 2 ion. 2K plus SO4 2 minus ions. So total 3 ions are forming. Whereas sodium chloride 2. More is the number of particles, lesser is the freezing point. So freezing point is inversely proportional to the number of particles. Question number 4, first option. Okay, next question number 5. Question number 5 you see there. A complex MX2 has absorbed and normal molar masses. Absorbed and normal molar masses 65.6 and 164 respectively. Calculate the apparent degree of ionization of MX2. Calculate the degree of ionization of MX2. See, we have a formula for colligative property. I is equal to normal molar mass divided by absorbed molar mass. Absorbed molar mass, that is 164. Normal molar mass is given 164. Absorbed mass is 65.6. That gives answer 2.5. I we are getting 2.5. Then what is the formula? Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Okay. So they are asking alpha. I value is 2.5 minus 1. N, MX2 they are giving. MX2 it contain total 3 particles. So 3 minus 1. If you solve that, you will get alpha 0.75. If I am taking in percentage, 75%. Okay. So what I am doing? I am using the Van 't Hoff factor definition. I is equal to normal molar mass divided by absorbed molar mass. They are given in the question, normal absorbed and normal molar mass are 65.6 and 164. 164 divided by 65.6, that gives answer 2.5. So alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Then we will get 75%. Right? That is why it is first option. Okay. Next question number 6. Question number 6. A solution of cane sugar is isotonic with 1% solution of a substance X. The molecular mass of X is. Okay, this type of problem I have solved in the class. Isotonic solution means which are having same osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure of sugar is equal to the osmotic pressure of 1% unknown substance X. Directly you can take W2 by M2 is equal to W2 by M2 of X. This is of sugar. This is of sugar. So W2, that is sugar, they have given 5 gram, molecular mass is 342, W2 is 1, divided by M2 we don't know. M2 of molecular mass of X, that is molecular mass of X is equal to 342 divided by 5. 342 divided by 5. See, roughly it is 5 ones, 5 6, then 4 will be there, 5 8s, roughly 68. So C option. Okay, question number 6 is third option. Okay, next question number 7. Which of the following aqueous solution will exhibit highest boiling point? Question number 7, they are asking related to boiling point. Which of the following will have highest boiling point? See here, boiling point of solution is directly proportional to number of particles. Concept is what? More is the number of solute particles are there, means less tendency to escape the solvent molecule to the surface of the liquid. So less vapors are produced. So we have to heat more such that solvent molecules present in the solution get sufficient kinetic energy so that they can escape to the surface of the liquid. Then the vapor pressure of that liquid is equal to the atmospheric pressure, then the liquid is going to boil. So what I want to say, boiling point is directly proportional to number of particles, and keep in mind vapor pressure is inversely proportional to number of particles. Vapor pressure is inversely proportional to number of particles. So question number 7. So then what happens here, where we are having more, you see, sodium sulfate, two sodium ions are there and one sulfate ion we have. So three particles are there, that is why that will be having more boiling point. Right, one student has given right answer, Mr. Hari Battle, okay, given option A, it is correct. Question number 7, option number A. Okay, question number 8. If A is the degree of dissociation of sodium sulfate, the Van 't Hoff factor I use to calculate the molecular mass is, if A is the degree of dissociation they have given, instead of alpha they are telling A. That you can say alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. So in place of alpha, what they have done? They have taken A. I am editing here itself. So that is A is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. I am editing the formula. Here I is for sodium sulfate. Sodium sulfate, 3 are there. A is the degree of dissociation of sodium sulfate, the Van 't Hoff factor I used for the calculation of molecular mass is. They wanted to have in terms of Van 't Hoff factor. Keep this A as it is, I you keep as it is, minus 1, where N is number of particles obtained after dissociation, that is 3. Sodium sulfate dissociate gives to Na plus and SO4 2 minus, that is 2. So then what happens? 2A is equal to I minus 1. I is equal to 1 plus 2a. So third option is correct. If a is the degree of dissociation of sodium sulfate, okay, a is the degree of dissociation of sodium sulfate, then van 't Hoff factor used for the calculating molecular mass. Okay, we have to derive like this. Question number 8 is third option. Question number 9. If a sodium sulfate is considered to be completely dissociated into cations and anions in the aqueous solution, the change in freezing point D, they have given, we can take even delta also or D also chalega. If the sodium sulfate is considered to be completely dissociated in a cations and anion in aqueous solution, the change in freezing point of water delta TF when 0.01 moles of sodium sulfate dissolved in 1 kg of water. They have given KF value. So here formula is delta TF is equal to I into KF into M. Why I am taking in the picture? Because sodium sulfate dissociate. If the solute is dissociating, then you have to take van 't Hoff factor correction term. So here I is equal to, in the question they have not given, but I am writing sodium sulfate Na2SO4 gives 2 Na plus as sulfate ion. So I is equal to 3. 2 Na plus plus 1 sulfate ion, I is equal to 3. Sodium sulfate gives 2 Na plus plus sulfate ion, I is equal to 3. So 3 into KF 1.86 molality. Molality they are asking you to calculate. Question number 9. They have given when 0.01 mole they are dissolving. So if you multiply this, we'll get 0.0558 Kelvin. That is B option. Okay. If sodium sulfate is considered to be completely dissociated into cations and anion in aqueous solution, change in free energy they are asking. Remember friends, you cannot take only delta TF is equal to KF into M, because sodium sulfate undergo dissociation. Then you may think that, sir, in the question I is not given, no sir, but by default you have to take that I is equal to 3. So ninth one, question for question number 9, third option is correct. Question number 10, a plant shrinks when it is kept in. Plant shrinks when it is possible, when you are keeping in more concentrated solution, that is hypertonic solution. Hypertonic solution means what? The solution whose osmotic pressure is more than the given solution. And our chemistry meaning is what? Hypertonic means more concentrated solution. So what happens? More concentrated means solute particles will be more. Okay. So hypertonic solution will be there. So plant cell shrinks when it is kept in hypertonic solution. Okay. Question number 11. Which of the following statement is not correct? See, I'll read all the options. From this end, I'll read. For the same solution, delta TB by delta TF is equal to KB by KF. It is correct. What is given, you know, delta TB by delta TF is equal to KB by KF. Correct expression it is. Molecular mass of acetic acid and benzoic acid is higher than the normal mass in cryoscopic method. That is correct, because they undergoes association. In the morning class itself, I said, they undergoes association. That is why it is correct only. C is correct. B, 1 molar sucrose solution and 1 molar glucose solution are isotonic. 1 molar sucrose solution and 1 molar glucose solutions are isotonic. See, when they are having same molarity, isotonic. Correct. 5% solution of sodium chloride and potassium chloride are said to be isomolar. No, they are not isomolar. They do not have same molarity. So then option A is incorrect statement. Some student has given, Bhaskar Reddy has given right answer. That is first option. Omkar Sakri has given right answer. Okay. Then question number 12. What weight of glycerol should be added to 600 grams of water in order to lower its freezing point by 10 degree? Just solve and tell me this answer. You solve and tell me answer for this. Okay. Question, what weight of glycerol should be added to 600 grams of water in order to lower its freezing point by 10 degree? Let me solve this question. Delta Tf is equal to, we have a formula, delta Tf is equal to Kf into W2 1000 divided by M2 into W1. What weight of glycerol should be, W2 mass of the solute they are asking, and its freezing point lowered 10 degree centigrade. Already delta Tf is given 1.8 degree centigrade per mole. W2 they are asking you to calculate into 1000 divided by M2 molecular mass of the solute, that is glycerol, is 92 gram per mole. 92 gram per mole into W1 600 gram. So if you solve this W2, if you are solving, then you will get answer W2 as 296.77 actually. 296.77, that is why B option is correct. Okay, Hari Battle, 12th option, question number 12, you are given first option, wrong man. No, it is not correct. Omkar Sakri has given right answer. 12th one is B, that is 297. Okay. Question number 13. Sprinkling of salt help in cleaning the snow covered roads in hills. The phenomena involves in the process. What is this? You know, in some cold countries and all, you might have seen in some movies and all, on the road, sometime, you know, more temperature is very less, means sometime what happens on the road itself, they are going to see this ice crystals are going to be formed on the road itself. So it is difficult to identify where is road. So in that case, what they will do, they will spray some salt like sodium chloride. They are going to spray there sodium chloride. If they are spraying, what happens, you know, throwing on the road itself, there the freezing point get decreases, the freezing point of water get decreases, so that time water will be there on the road itself, so road is visible. That is the meaning of that. Sprinkling of salt helps in clearing the snow covered roads in hills. The phenomena, it is because of depression in freezing point. Okay, depression in freezing point concept will help. What is that concept you try to understand? Think that water freezes at 0 degree centigrade. H2O. We know that water freezes at 0 degree centigrade. If I'm adding to this solution, if I'm adding sodium chloride, then what happens when you're adding a non-volatile solute into a solvent? Freezing point decreases. Freezing point decreases means water is not going to freeze at 0 degree centigrade. It freezes lesser temperature, like minus 4 degree, minus 5 degree. So atmosphere depends upon the atmosphere temperature. So there what they do, they will spray the sodium chloride so that water is not going to freeze on the road. So snow is not forming on the road, so that it is not freezes out, road is clear. That is a concept they are using there. Okay, question number 13 is B. Question number 14. Which of the following is not an industrial or biological importance of osmosis? Think over this question. Okay. Question number 13 is B. 14. Which of the following is not an, sir, what about option A? Rama Devi, you're asking me option, right? Sachin Bamnali, 14th. D you have given. Yes, Sachin Bamnali has given right answer. Rama Devi, right answer. Nazar, right answer. Yes, students are answering. Students are answering well. Okay. Okay, then it is fourth option only. Yes, no, hurry, you know, given second option, no man. Salting prevents, salting means it to prevent bacterial action, that is correct only, pickles. Okay, question number 14, that is fourth option. It is not because of our osmosis, it is because of capillary action. It is because of capillary action. The filling of ink in a fountain pen, it is there, the capillary action concept is there. Okay, some student is asking, Rama Devi are asking question 13, question why not A option. Okay, see, lowering of vapor pressure of the snow, see, snow press, there is, your target is on water, not on the snow. If your water is not freezing, then how snow is going to be formed, madam? If water itself is not forming, because we are adding a solute, water is itself is not converting into ice, then how snow is going to be formed? So you target on the water. So water should not freeze out. So that is why, Rama Devi, I'm not going for, come back to question number 14, that is D. Question number 15, if 1 gram of solute is dissolved in 50 grams of the solvent, elevation in boiling point is 1 Kelvin. This type of problems I solved in class. Question number 15. Okay, that is the they're asking molar boiling constant of the solvent. 1 gram of solute is dissolved in 50 grams of the solvent. Elevation in boiling point is 1 Kelvin. Okay. So delta TB is equal to here KB into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 W1. Okay. Delta TB is given here 1 Kelvin. KB, they are asking you to calculate. W2 is 1 gram into 1000 gram divided by molecular mass, 50 grams of solvent and elevation in boiling point is 1 Kelvin, molar boiling constant of the solvent. Okay, this is molecular mass is given in the question itself. It is 50 gram per mole and W1 dissolved in 50 grams. If you solve that, we'll get KB answer 2.5. Yes, 15C. Rama Devi given right answer. Omkar Sakari given right answer. Sachin Bamnali given right answer. Hari given right answer. Okay. Question number 15. Then question number 16. Which of the following will have the highest freezing point at 1 atmosphere? Yes, think and tell me this one. Because in the beginning of my class itself, I said how the freezing point is depending. Based on that, you get the answer. Thank you. Yes, let us see which of the following have highest freezing point. See, freezing point depends on what? For the same concentration of different solvent, colligative property depends upon the I. One line you remember, I'll write that. For the same concentration of different solvent, colligative property directly proportional to I. For the same concentration of different solvent, any colligative property directly proportional to I. See, here I value for sodium chloride, it is I value for sodium chloride 2, I value for sugar solution 1, I value for barium chloride 3, I value for ferric chloride is 4. So then, which is your option? So here, for the same different, any colligative property depends upon the I. Which of the following will have highest freezing point, more freezing point? Which one will be there? Which will be having more freezing point? Yes, 16 is B answer. 16 is B because it is having less particles, more freezing point. Freezing point is inversely proportional to the number of particles. Here one, because it is a covalent compound, sugar, urea, glucose, these are all the particles, use only one. They are covalent compound, they will not dissociate and give ions. So that I am going for 16th one, B option. 17th one. If alpha is the degree of dissociation of sodium sulfate, Van 't Hoff factor, it is repeated, I think it is repeated, that is C. Next question I'll go. A solution X, when dissolved in a solvent, associated with to form pentamer. There is a solution, that is 5A are there, the solution X dissolves, in the class I have taken A, 5X gives pentamer, X5. For that we have a formula, I is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 1 by n. 1 minus, in the bracket, 1 minus 1 by n. So if you, the very important formula, I is equal to 1 minus, in the bracket, 1 minus 1 by n. So that gives 1 minus 1 by 5. So that gives 0.2. That gives 0.2. So question number 18th is third option. Okay, question number 19, what will be the freezing point of 0.5 molar potassium chloride solution? The molar freezing point constant of water is 1.86. What will be the freezing point of 0.5 molar potassium chloride solution? The molar freezing point constant of water is 1.86 degrees centigrade per molar. So go for the formula, delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into M. They are asking freezing point in degrees centigrade. We know that water freezes at 0 degrees centigrade minus freezing point of solution is equal to potassium chloride, I is equal to 2. For potassium chloride gives K plus Cl minus, therefore I is equal to 2. Kf is given 1.86 degrees centigrade per molar. Molality is given 0.5. So you see here 0.5 is nothing but 1 by 2. 0.5, this 2 get cancelled. So then Tf is equal to, you bring this 0 minus 0.186 degrees centigrade. That is, answer is minus -1.86 degree centigrade only. Okay, option question number 19, first option. What I have done, I have used the formula delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into M. Here I is equal to 2 because potassium chloride dissociates and produces I is equal to 2. So that is why, 1 point, that is I is equal to 2, I value substituted to Kf is 1.86, M is 0.5, because in the question it is given 0.5. 0 minus Tf is equal to 0 minus, or else directly Tf I am taking, Tf is equal to, you bring this side, 0 degree minus 1.86, that answer is -1.86. Question number 19 is first option. Question number 20, which of the following has the highest freezing point? Question number 20. See, same thing. Here, freezing point is inversely proportional to number of particles. Freezing point is inversely proportional to number of particles. Here, sodium chloride gives 2. Aluminum chloride gives 4. Potassium chloride gives 2. This gives 1. So this will be having more freezing point. Freezing point is inversely proportional to the number of particles. That is why for question number 20, D option is correct. Okay. Question number 21. Why is the molecular mass determined by measuring colligative property in case of some solute molecules? Abnormal in the morning class is said because of dissociation and association. If the solute is undergoing dissociation or association, then it goes to abnormal. So molecular mass is becoming abnormal. It is because of association or dissociation of solute molecules. Okay. Next, question number 22. What amount of calcium chloride is dissolved in 2 liters of water so that its osmotic pressure is 0.5 atmosphere at 27 degrees centigrade? Formula is phi is equal to W2 by M2 RT by V. Okay. They are asking what amount of calcium chloride is dissolved in 2 liters of water so that osmotic pressure is 0.5. W2 they have given. They are asking you to calculate molecular mass of calcium chloride. Molecular mass of calcium chloride is 111 gram per mole. Okay. R value is 0.0821. Then temperature you have to substitute. Temperature is given in the question 27 degrees centigrade. Convert 27 degrees centigrade into Kelvin. That is 300 Kelvin. Okay. And volume 2 liter they have given. See, osmotic pressure is given. W2. M2 0.0821 300 2 liter. So if you substitute all the data in this, then we'll get W2 and Vanta factor value is given to Vanta factor I is given. Students, you see that I also am taking the count multiplied by Vanta factor 2.47. remember, if you solve together, you'll get 1.82, D option. Okay. What amount is dissolved in 2 liters of water so that osmotic pressure is 27 degrees centigrade? So formula is pi is equal to ICRT. Concentration nothing but W2 by M2 V RT. Substitute all, we get W2 as 1.82. Question number 22, D option. Question number 22 is D option. Once again, you can see Vanta factor I value has substituted here 2.47. Okay, osmotic pressure is 0.5, W2 is given, M2 is given, R is given, T is given, volume is given, then you will get 1.82. Next, for which of the following solute the Vanta factor is not greater than 1? Not greater than 1 they are telling. See, for this I is equal to 2, for this I is equal to 3. For this I is equal to 5. Why I is equal to 5? For this I'll tell you, potassium ferrocyanide dissociates and produces 4K plus FeCN6 minus 4. 4K plus FeCN6 minus 4. Okay, and this is one only. So actually not greater than 1, even I cannot write equal to 1. The reason is that it is a covalent compound, it will not dissociate 100%, so that it is less than 1 only, one particle. So Vanta factor I value come less than 1 only. Vanta factor I is less than 1 only, right? So question number 23, D option. Question number 23, D option. For which of the following solute the Vanta factor is not greater than 1? Question number 24. The Vanta factor 0.005 molar aqueous solution potassium chloride is 1.95. The degree of ionization of potassium chloride is, they are asking degree of. Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Vanta factor is given 1.95 minus 1. N value for potassium chloride, it is 2. 2 minus 1. So then what happens? That gives 2 minus 1, 1 only. 1.95 minus 1, that is 0.95. 24th is option number A. Question number 24, option number A. The Vanta factor of 0.005 molar aqueous solution of potassium chloride is 1.95. See, if they are not given, means I will take I is equal to 2 for potassium chloride. If they are not given, by default I will take it as 2, but they are given. One Vanta factor I is equal to 1.95. So degree of ionization of potassium chloride is, that is 0.95, because we have a formula, alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1, I value is 1.95 minus 1 divided by N value is 2, because potassium chloride ionized to gives K plus and Cl minus, so N is equal to 2. So N is equal to 2 I have taken there. Question number 24 is A. Next, question number 25. Which of the following aqueous solution should have highest boiling point? Highest boiling point. See that, friends, concentration here 1 molar, 1 molar, 1 molar, 1 molar. Here sodium hydroxide I value is 2, sodium sulfate I value is 3, ammonium nitrate I value is 2, potassium nitrate is 2. Should have highest boiling point. Boiling point is directly proportional to I value. Boiling point is directly proportional to I value. So that is why it is this. Number of particles are 3, because sodium sulfate Na2SO4 ionizes to gives 2Na plus plus SO4 minus 2. Question number 25, B. Which of the following aqueous solution should have highest boiling point? Okay, 2Na plus SO4 minus 2. Question number 25 is B. In comparison to 0.01 molar solution of glucose, depression in freezing point of 0.01 molar magnesium chloride solution is, in comparison to a 0.01 molar solution of glucose, the depression in freezing point of 0.01 molar magnesium chloride will be, see, this is one particle, glucose is one particle, glucose produces one particle, it is one particle, whereas magnesium chloride gives three particles. Magnesium chloride is giving three particles. Then we know that comparison of glucose, the depression in freezing point is about three times, obviously, because you see here it is magnesium chloride produces three particles Mg2 plus plus 2Cl minus. So that is the way for question number 26, C option, right? Many of you have given right answer: Akash, Prajwal, Omkar, Rama, Nazar, Nitin, Hari. Okay, they have, you're all given right answer, right? It is option number C. Question number 26 is C. Okay, next question number 27. An unripe mango placed in a concentration salt solution to prepare pickle still because it gains water due to osmosis, it loses water due to reverse osmosis, it gains water due to reverse osmosis. Okay, it loses water due to osmosis. Which is your option for question number 27? Which is your option? You see there. Question number 27, that is waiting for your options. You heard about exosmosis. In biology, this term is used, exosmosis. Yes, Omkar Sakri, given right answer. Then D it is. It is D. Question number 27, D. Question number 28, relative lowering of vapor pressure. This is, that they are asking for the properties. Question number 28 is D option. You can see later, they are asking which is colligative property based solvent, how the osmosis occurs. The question concept is related to osmosis, colligative property it is. Okay, question number 29, just you see this, I can edit, this is small letter M. Now you see the option, which option is correct, friends? KB unit is, what is the unit of KB for question number 29? The unit of KB is Kelvin kg per mole, so it goes to this. Molality unit is mole per kg. Molarity unit is mole per liter. Strength is in mole gram per liter. So question number 29, B option is correct. Question number 29 is related to, question number 29 is related to units of terms. Okay, that is question number 29. 30, which of the following statement is not correct? Osmotic pressure of a solution is given by the relation pi is equal to mRT. It is correct only. The correct order of osmotic pressure of 0.2 molar aqueous solution of each of the solution. See, osmotic pressure is depends upon the number of particles. So here calcium chloride, three particles are there. Sodium chloride, two are there. Acetic acid, one. Glucose is one. So this order is correct only. This order is correct only. Okay, acetic acid ionizes partially, gives acetate and H plus ions. Okay, this is covalent compound. Compared to sodium chloride, dissociation of acetic acid is less than only. Compared to sodium chloride, dissociation of acetic acid is less only. So question number 30, third option. Two solutions of sucrose of same molality prepared in different solvent will have same elevation in boiling point. How? Two solutions of sucrose of same molality prepared in different solvent. Different solvent means how it is possible? Different, you see. If solvent is different, vapor pressure will be different. If vapor pressure is different, boiling point will be different. So for question number 30, it is C. Okay, question number 30, C is the option. Question number 31. Question number 31. Which of the following relations is not correctly matched with the formula? This is alpha is equal to I minus for association. This is correct. For dissociation, it is wrong. It is wrong. What is correct then? Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. So it is wrong. Relative lowering of vapor pressure, it is C is correct. Elevation in boiling point, even that is also correct only. Right. For question number 31, D option is correct. In the sense, this supposed to be, they are asking not correctly matched. Not correctly matched. So this is not correctly matched. Right. It should be alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Question number 31. Arrange the following aqueous solution in the order of their increasing boiling points. See again, boiling point order, you see that I'll help you for this. I is equal to 2, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 3, I is equal to 2. Okay. See here, thing is that arrange the following aqueous solution in the order of increasing boiling point. Boiling point is directly proportional to I, no doubt. So Roman letter 3 gets more priority. So here sodium chloride we have, concentration you see there, 10 to the 4 of minus 4, concentration matters, 10 to the 4 of minus 4, 10 to the 4 of minus 4, 10 to the 4 of minus 3, 10 to the 4 of minus 2 we have here. Friends, you see that chances is there for the confusion. Sodium chloride concentration is more. When concentration is more, there is a chance of getting more and more particles. So boiling point is directly proportional to I, no doubt. But even concentration also matters there, concentration. So that is why for question number 32, C option is correct. C option is correct. Somebody is asking, molarity is different. We can't take directly proportional with I. Yes, correct. You're right. That's what I'm telling. Here concentration matters. You cannot take this. Concentration matters there. Of course, boiling point is directly proportional to I, but concentration is not same. I have given one line, when there is a same concentration, then boiling point is directly proportional to I value. Here concentration is not same. So boiling point, you have to see which is having more concentration, that produces more particle, that boiling point will be more. That is why this is 10 to the power of minus 2 is greater than 10 to the power of minus 3, greater than 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay, so that is why 4 is more than 3, 3 is more than 1, 1 is more than 2. Why this is least priority? Because it is a covalent compound, dissociation is less as compared to sodium chloride. When there is a case of same concentration, this is 10 to the 4 of minus 4 molar, this is 10 to the 4 of minus 4 molar, both are having same concentration, that time you have to see I value. Which is having more I value, its boiling point will be more. Which is having more I value, its boiling point will be more. So 32 is third option. Clear? 2 points I'm telling you here. Boiling point is directly proportional to concentration of the solution. Suppose we have same concentration, then you have to see I value. So 32 is C. 33, you see that we have three aqueous solutions of sodium chloride labeled as A, B, C with a concentration. We have three aqueous solutions We have three aqueous solutions, sodium chloride, labeled as A, B and C with a concentration 0.1 molar, 0.01 molar, 0.01 molar respectively. The value of Van 't Hoff factor for these solutions will be in the order of Van 't Hoff factor value they are asking. See, these compounds are sodium chloride labeled as A, B, C. Concentration 0.1, 0.01, 0.001. The value of Van 't Hoff factor for these solutions will be in the order of. In the order of. Question number 33 is third option. Question number 33 is a third option because what we have there, we have a same concentration. Their concentration is different, but the Van 't Hoff factor, how it is dissociating matters. Van 't Hoff factor, sodium chloride only it is there, dissociate gives two particles only. 33 is C. 34. Which of the following will have same value of Van 't Hoff factor as set of this? Potassium ferrocyanide is having 5 particles. Potassium produces 5 particles, aluminum also produces 5, that is why A option is correct. Okay, then question number 35, the elevation boiling point of a solution. This is easy question, elevation boiling point concept related it is. You can find out delta TB is equal to I into KB into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. So that gives a Van 't Hoff factor value. Van 't Hoff factor value is given, that is magnesium chloride 3 into, substitute all the datas, 3 into 0.52 W2 mass of the solute, 9.43 into 1000 divided by molecular mass of the magnesium chloride is given, 94.3 W1, 1 kg. If you solve that, the elevation in boiling point, you will get first option. Okay, delta TB is equal to I into KB into W2 by 1000 by M2 by W1. Question number 36. The correct formula of the compound is, See, question is like this. You have to find out I value. Delta TF is equal to I into KF into M. Freezing point depression is given 0.054. I is equal to KF is 1.8, KF is 1.8, okay, and molality is given 0.001. If you solve this, you will get I value as 3. So I value is 3 means 3 particles will be there. I value means 3 particles will be there. So the formula, 3 particles means here platinum, this compound Cl2 after ionization gives same complex plus 2 Cl minus ions. Total 3 particles are forming. 36 is C. See, what is that? What is the concept here? The coordination sphere ions will not split up, only this will come out. Coordination sphere one particle, 2 Cl minus ion together, 2 particles total. 3. So this formula how I got from the Van 't Hoff factor I value. So that is, you can see this. Question number 36. We are finding I value. From the I value, I am deriving the formula. 36 is C. Question number 37. Direct concept it is A. 37 is direct one. 38 also direct, because this I explained in the class. Question number 38, it is D. Okay. Peaky curve shows a solvent. This is solvent. This is solution. This is elevation in boiling point. 38 is D. Okay, this is for the solvent. This is for the solution. Elevation in boiling point. 38 is D option. 39. A 5% solution of cane sugar. Question number 39. It's a big problem. How to solve this problem is, see, delta TF you have to find out first. You have to find out delta TF. Else I'll tell you how to solve this question number 39. Delta TF is equal to KF into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. Delta TF freezing point, you see that they have given 273.15 minus, we have freezing point of water is 273.15 and they have given it freezes, solution freezes at 271.1 Kelvin. So KF into 5 gram into 1000 divided by M2. Molecular mass are given 342 into 95. So this is one thing. Difference is how much? 2.15 is equal to same thing you write. KF into 5 gram into 1000 divided by KF into 5 gram into 1000 divided by 342 into 95. This is equation number 1. Same way we can write for equation number 2. Delta TF you don't know. This is 5 gram they are taking, 1000 divided by molecular mass of sugar, glucose is 180 and that is also 95. 5% solution that one. Okay. Then what you do? Divide equation 2 by 1. Then what will get? Delta TF is equal to 342 by 180 into 2.15. So delta TF, this is, we know that freezing point of water is 273.15. freezing point of solution we don't know, so this gives 4.085. then TF is equal to 269.07 Kelvin. Freezing point of the solution is this. So what I did, you see, first you take the formula, substitute delta TF, find, put equation number 1 for first solution, 5% cane sugar solution. This is for cane sugar solution. Next one they are asking for glucose. Glucose we don't know anything, freezing point we don't know. Delta TF is equal to KF into, that is also 5%, so 5 gram into 1000 divided by 180 into 95. Divide equation 2 by 1. Then what we get? Delta TF is equal to 340 by 180 into this. This together gives 4.085. Freezing point of water is 273.15. TF is equal to, you bring this side, 269.07, you will get answer. Okay, so question number 39 is 269.07. Question number 39 is 269.07. Okay, this is for question number 39 is B. Question number 40, this is again the concept. Question number 40, the graph they are asking regarding freezing point. PQ represent liquid state. This area in the class I have represented, this is a liquid state of solvent. Okay, QR, solid state of the solvent. This is frozen liquid. This is QR, represent solid state of solvent. Then ST, that is a liquid state of the solution. Okay, a liquid state of the solution. Question number 40 is a B option. Right, so many students have given right answer. Good to know this one. Okay students, this is my plan for today's class. 40 questions, maybe I have discussed it fast. You can make it slow, playback, you can go in a video playback, you reduce the playback, then automatically this class will become slow. So you'll understand all the concept. Even though you are not getting anything, I'll upload the question paper and solution for this video class. You can see there. If you're not getting anything, you are free to ask in WhatsApp.